Yeah, hello again, everybody. My name is Kurtz.
And my name is Gravity McGee!
Bam! Gravity McGee.
Yes. It's my other middle name.
I'm thinking there's got to be a way we can make a joke about some kind of anti-gravity in your name so that we can say, he goes both ways.
It's a joke. Anyway, I'm trying to figure out, like, okay, so as near as I can figure, when gravity goes up, like, gravity's going up, if I can hit that button right as gravity pulls me down, it'll bring me, like, down and to the right, under the buzzsaw. But I gotta really, really closely time that. So I'm gonna turn up the audio, just for now.
It's okay, we still love you.
Well, I mean, they can't hear that the audio's higher.
No, but we're gonna, like...
I know. I can't...
Now.
Okay, I can just barely hear that. No, it's... Oh, well... No, it's gotta be while gravity is up, right as it goes down. So, like, hold on. Dang it!
Oh, you've timed that a little too well.
Yeah.
And
sorry.
You died.
Sorry, kid. I like how it brings my corpse up as well. Okay.
Because you are still a physics thing to be acted upon.
A physics body is the technical term. Okay, listening. Uh-oh. Okay. So, problem. It doesn't actually, like, bring gravity down and that way. It just brings it that way. Which is...
does not affect your trajectory.
Yeah, it's something I don't know how to fix. Yeah. I mean, here.
Didn't you get past this before?
No. I tried to walk past it, but it didn't work. Oh, almost. I'm trying it a slightly different way.
Damn timing puzzles.
Every time. It worked!
Oh.
What? What? I'm confused. What's...
What the hell has happened?
Did we just enter the Matrix?
We are floating.
I'm confused.
It appears that we're not dead.
I mean, we're kind of ragdoll and our eyes are closed, so we might be dead, but I think this is a dead on purpose sort of thing? I don't actually know what's happening. What is going on?
I have no idea. This is... They've obviously slowed everything down.
Well, clearly.
But I'm pretty sure he's dead.
I am so confused right now. I am so, so confused.
What's the name of the game?
Limbo.
Maybe we just left Limbo.
Perhaps.
Maybe we're dead, finally.
Can I get up in some way? Can I do things? Do we have any alternative besides sitting here?
I would love one of those, action...
Nope,
we have liftoff.
We're alive! Just very unconscious.
To be fair, when you cross planes in a different world, that tends to happen.
It's gotta be harsh, man. Ooh, well, that was a hell of a nap. All right. Let's get back to work, I guess.
How much you want to bet we're at the beginning?
I don't know, but how much you want to bet this is the end of the game? What is it with games recently and, like, their endings sneaking the hell up on us? I think this is the end.
Oh, it's the girl we saw.
Yeah, it's that girl from earlier. What's up, girl from earlier?
Oh, God.
If she turns around to have, like, a monster face.
Yeah, but that's just about to see.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
Okay, this fade to black bullshit is really getting under my skin. Fuck this game. Fuck this game. I'm not analyzing this shit. Fuck that.
Okay. So...
Fuck it, I'm not doing it.
Oh, it's unfading to black. To not black, I think. Something's happening. Maybe.
I'm pretty sure it's just the background.
I think you might be right. So let's talk about this a little bit, because we've still got time.
Fuck this game.
Fuck
it. Don't want.
So Kurtz isn't a fan.
Fuck this game.
I have to agree, although a little less rudely, that I don't think...
I don't like having my balls played with and then just get up and walk out. Fuck that.
I don't think this is a game we're going to feature on the main show unless it does something in the next, like, 5 seconds to change everything. And I don't think it's going to.
I see flies.
Nope, implying, we're back at the beginning.
Implying two dead bodies.
We are back at the beginning. I just, like, it... I can see why people liked it. And I didn't hate it. Even towards the end, I have to admit, we were having fun.
Yeah,
we were enjoying it.
Very good puzzle design.
I was very antagonistic towards it, because it was very antagonistic towards me, especially on my first playthrough. But it you know was relatively well designed. It had some genuinely creepy moments in there with the spider and such. But I don't think it's a game that like tried to do much story wise. The story was, there was a girl. Go find girl. Watch out for spider. Which is basically the story of Mario, just like, with a Koopa instead of a spider. So, like, maybe if we did a design show, maybe this game could show up. Because it's got some puzzle design that is at the very least interesting. But I don't think. This game it almost doesn't have a story.
It's got the bare threads of one to tie everything together.
Yeah, but it's like those are it's really just like scraps.
It sort of robbed you of that payoff of.
Kinda, yeah. It's like you're in a forest, and then there are like children that are evil and killing other children, and then there's a spider, and then you're in a city place, and then you're in like a factory, and there's water, and then
gravity.
You're in the forest again, and then there's gravity, and then.
Find the girl.
And that's the entire game. Like, it's just a series of settings, basically, to have your puzzles in.
Also, that whole little thing where you, like, crash through the barrier at the end, like, there's no explanation what the barrier was.
Yeah, it feels like this game, like, got to the end and realized, oh shit, we need a story. We started out with, like, a hint at one and then never followed up on that. Better do that now. Now, is it possible we missed stuff? Absolutely. Is it possible that we aren't giving the game its due credit because we missed stuff? That's also possible. This playthrough, though, I mean, there wasn't a story emphasis at all. Does that make it a bad game? No, not at all. Don't ever.
I think it's a fantastic game.
Yeah.
I just don't like having. Like, if you're going to shoehorn in a story. At the end. Like, you had a wonderful beginning.
Right.
But if you're going to forget about it until the end and realize, oh, wait, we did this thing, we got to follow up on it, and then you don't follow up on it, even though you give a hint that you're going to follow up on it, that's a little infuriating.
I feel almost like this game would have been improved by not including that last segment.
Yeah.
By even just doing something as simple as looping the game over or dying in a way you can't come back from, or fuck it, this game is called Limbo. You have the Christian mythology built right into it. Just have him ascend to goddamn heaven, or something.
Like, have him die. Like, I thought he was dead. I'd have been fine with that.
Yeah, that like, and it would have fit the game perfectly.
It feels like they got to that part, they killed him, and then they remembered the beginning.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like this game was probably way overrated in terms of, like, its importance. Because when this game came out, for a while, it was all people could talk about. And it did sort of set the standard for indie puzzle platformers, of which we have millions now, in part because this game exists. So, in conclusion, good game, we enjoyed it, Kurtz is choking on candy corn, but we're probably not going to make it into a full episode, despite him choking. It was just not, there wasn't enough there for us, guys. We're sorry, but we hope you enjoyed the ride. And we'll look forward to playing with you again in our next game, whatever that may be. Still choking.
Still choking.
Yep. until next time, I've been Run Bam Run Faster.
And I'm gonna get some water.
And we'll see you guys later. Bye.